there, Bonnie Newland, registered dietitian nutritionist, and today I'm inviting you back into my kitchen to talk about beverages. I know many of us will grab a drink if we're out on the go or if we're at the grocery store and we see that refrigerated cold case of drinks calling our name, or maybe we're at a sports game with the kiddos and we grab a drink for us and a drink for them, and we have no idea really how much sugar is in some of these things. It's almost like we're drinking candy. So I just wanted to give a little bit more awareness to how much sugar is in some of these drinks, and then give you a guideline so that you know how much sugar we should consume and how much might be too much. So the American Heart Association has a recommendation for added sugar. For women, we should have no more than 6 teaspoons of added sugar daily, and that's the equivalent of about 100 calories. For men, they should have no more than 9 grams of sugar added sugar daily, which is the equivalent of about 150 calories. So that's not very much. If you look on the back of a package, you'll see that that adds up really quickly. And I'm gonna grab some popular drinks here and just give you a demonstration of how much sugar is in them. So if you decide to go to McDonald's and you supersize and you get a 32-ounce drink, the amount of sugar in there is going to be 28 teaspoons of sugar. That's right, 28 teaspoons of sugar in this 1 32-ounce drink. So you can see for men and women, this is way over the limit. That's how much sugar is in there. Just crazy to actually see that. If you grab a large, it's crazy that this used to be a large, but it's about 20 ounces, and that's about 18 teaspoons of sugar. So again, still over the limit for men and women. 18 teaspoons of sugar in a 20-ounce regular beverage from one of our favorite fast food restaurants. And then if you grab the 12-ounce, which is the small, again, it's still a lot of sugar. This is 10 teaspoons. So this would be just over the equivalent of what a man needs for an entire day, 9 teaspoons or less. And this is for the 12-ounce drink. If you go with a Happy Meal and you get 8 ounces, you're still getting 7 teaspoons of sugar. So you can see that's a decent amount of sugar, 7 teaspoons, still too much for a woman's daily allotment. And that's with a Happy Meal. So those are from fast food establishments. If we go to a 7-Eleven or a Wawa or a gas station, and we decide we wanna get this real big supersize, a 42-ounce beverage, this one has about 38.5 teaspoons of sugar. 38 teaspoons of sugar, 38.5 in this. That's how much sugar you're getting if you're drinking one of these supersized beverages. And then these monster drinks. I see these all over. I see people drinking them all over. One, they're full of caffeine, which is a stimulant and not necessarily the best for our cardiac system. And two, a lot of the varieties have sugar. So this one has 13.5 teaspoons of sugar in this one monster beverage. So not good for many reasons. And then I'm gonna pull up an iced tea. So this one looks healthy, right? It says 100% natural. It has pomegranate and blueberry in it, so that sounds pretty healthy, so that might be something that we go for. But if you look in here, it has 7.9 teaspoons of sugar. You can't see really the sugar in there, but this one has 7.9 teaspoons of sugar. And then the old standby, Coca-Cola, right? So if we grab a good old-fashioned Coke, we're gonna get 13.1 teaspoons of sugar in this 20-ounce bottle. At least I think it's 20 ounces. 16.9 ounces, even less, oh my goodness. 16.9 ounces and you're getting 200 calories from sugar, or 13.1 teaspoons. And Mountain Dew, right? So here's another one that I see, especially a lot of teenagers drink Mountain Dew. This one has 18.3 teaspoons of sugar. 18.3 teaspoons of sugar, 290 calories. And Coke, I know people are always the Coke or the Pepsi battle here. This is 13.1 teaspoons in this one bottle of Pepsi. And then apple juice. A lot of people think, okay, well, I'll avoid all of the sodas and I'll get an apple juice. One, you wanna make sure that you get 100% pure apple juice, but not any with added sugar. This one has 13.3 teaspoons of sugar, this little apple juice, and it's only 16 ounces. Same with this little Florida's Natural Orange Juice. This has 6.7 grams of sugar, and it doesn't tell how many are added and how many are natural. So that's another thing. On some of the newer labels, it will say sugar, and then it will say added sugar. So you would know that the added sugars are the ones that we wanna pay particular attention to. And then the last thing I have here is an electrolyte drink, a Gatorade drink, and this is a smaller bottle. This one is, I must need my glasses to see how many ounces this is. It's 10 ounces, and this has 5 teaspoons of sugar in it. 5 teaspoons of sugar in this smaller Gatorade bottle. So I think that kind of sums up all of these beverages. I didn't even talk about sweet tea, but that's pretty equal or higher to what the fast food soda beverages were. So just keep that in mind. Drinking tea is not necessarily better. It's loaded with sugar unless you're making it yourself. Nowadays, you can get some good alternatives. There's several carbonated drinks that have the effervescence of a soda, but they just have natural sweeteners in them. One is Spindrift. That one has the bubbles in it, but it uses 100% fruit juice to kind of sweeten it. It's not a super sweet, but it does give you sort of a hint of flavor. And there are some little sticks that you can add in to just water if you absolutely need a flavor. Or maybe you can infuse it with some berries or things yourself. Another thing that I like to do is I brew hot tea and then I let it cool and I use that as my cold beverage throughout the summer, and in the winter I just drink it hot. But that's another option. There's some really great varieties of herbal teas out there that don't have the caffeine or any of the sugar. So I encourage you to try some of those tricks and to drink water. We should be drinking about half our body weight in fluid ounces of water. So if you weigh 100 pounds, you want to drink about 50 ounces of water a day to make sure that you stay well hydrated. Remember that water is the school bus for all of these nutrients that you take in, and you want to get to all your cells delivered safely. So make sure you get your water in. Have a great day. Bye.